My field of expertise is what they call epidemiology. I look at the causes, the risk factors for diseases, and I do that by comparing patients with a disease with healthy people, for example. We have more data, but exposures have gone down. There's a shift in the data we have. Even if all my studies are negative, I'm happy because no one is at risk. We are taught within our training, within our education, that you should analyze the data in great depth. There is lots of trust in academics, which is okay, I think, which is legitimate to have, but it should be safeguarded. And that's why I'm now working on a guideline on responsible epidemiologic research practice. Do these researchers really have a protocol? Have they really followed the basic principles of science? If you submit a manuscript, you should also provide me with the protocol. You should even provide me with the data, with the raw data, so we can check whether or not something is wrong. I understand that people are very afraid of conflicts of interest. As I was with industry, I found it a big insult. It implies that me, from being from the industry, would withhold information about the toxicity of a chemical and then have the chemical put on the market. I could go to jail. Everyone has some sort of interest in it. The NGOs don't have a reason of living, of being there, if there's no issue. They will not be able to get contributions in or funding in if there's no issue. So they also have a conflict of interest. You have many players. You have the academics, you have NGOs, you have industry, you have journalists, you have politicians. Sometimes these journal articles are taken to politicians and they are used to convince politicians that they should do something about it. And if the politician gets the idea that there's something to act upon, then they will do it, which is fine. But they have to be very sure that this piece of evidence that they are going to act upon is well balanced. I would always be critical, regardless of where the information comes from. And being critical means that you have to understand how the information has been collected, what the quality, what the reliability is. We should have evidence-based politics or evidence-based public decision making, which I don't think that is really happening. EU has scientific advisory committees, and these are experts. What a parliamentarian should not do is ignore what these scientific advisory panels say. You have to learn from the past. Don't point your finger at the past, maybe, but improve things. And what I see today in most academic environments is that they acknowledge that there should be more standard operating procedures, there should be more transparency and more accountability.